Hello everyone, today's Storing Fat People! Today is a little special today, because today is my Storing Rex 1 year anniversary! So yeah, it's been 1 year from last year today that I've been doing these reaction videos. And yeah, just before I start today's video, I just wanted to tell you the little story about why I started this and all that. So, over a year ago, a couple years ago, I joined the Barbie fandom. I've been a big fan of that. And my first intro of the reaction videos was AC Race Best Barbie's Reacts. I watched his first video I saw of him was the Barbie's React to Teens React to MLP. And that's what really got me to join the fandom. And then I started watching other reactors like Jack D. Herbert, Big Rob, Alex Tsai, and all those people, and seeing them doing their reaction videos, Twitter videos. And I thought, I might as well give it a chance. So, a year ago of today, or like a day or two ago, I got my wisdom teeth out, so I had to stay at my parents' house for a while, and I didn't have much else to do, so I thought I'd get my camera out. I went to my YouTube app on my Xbox 360, and I recorded my reaction to Janimation's Bud Adventures, the pilot episode. So, yeah, I did that over a year ago, and I've done many reaction videos since then. So, I guess, first, I want to thank all the people who inspired me to do these. I guess I should thank Janimations for creating the video I first reacted to. And, of course, I want to thank you guys, to all my fans, subscribers, to all our people who've been following me for a year. I would not have gotten this far without you guys. I've gotten, like, almost 1,200 subscribers on my YouTube channel. That's very awesome. And so I just want to thank all the guys for helping me out. So I guess I should get to today's reaction video, which today I'm going to be doing to MLP Comic Dub Marathon. It's a lot like I did with the SFN Ponies Marathon I did when I got 1,000 subscribers. And like that, I'm not going to do just one or two. I'm going to be doing 10, react to 10 MLP Comic Dubs. So yeah, it's great. Quite a bit here. So this first MLP comic dub is called MLP FIM Key Comic on Comic Dub. It's Not My Wallet by Eduardo. So I used to tell from the title one that this is a parody of a SpongeBob episode where SpongeBob Patrick tried to turn Mander into a good guy, and this little part where Mander's trying to give Patrick his wallet but he won't take it. So I just tell it's gonna be funny. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started with the first one. First, I just want a quick sip from my mug. That's it. Alright, station myself here. Alright, we're gonna start this first one in 3, 2, 1, day.
Goodness lesson number 1. You see some pony drop their wallet. What did you do?
Excuse me, miss.
Discord.
But I do believe that you've dropped your wallet.
What?
Doesn't look familiar to me.
What? I just saw you drop it. Here.
Yeah.
No, it's not mine.
The voice actress.
It is yours. I'm trying to be a good guy and return it to you.
Return what to who?
You're doing a pretty good job. I don't know.
Aren't you Pink Amina Diane Pie?
Yep.
And this is your ID.
Yep.
I found this ID in this wallet. And if that's the case, then this must be your wallet.
Your wallet.
That makes sense to me.
Then take it.
That's not my wallet.
Just quick reaction.
Take your wallet back now, or I'll rip your legs off!
No, wrong.
Oh, they're tickling.
Good guys don't rip other ponies' legs off.
Make it stop! Make it stop!
You've got the same music playing. The cast, Discord, music, SpongeBob SquarePants, comic book, SpongeBob SquarePants, laughter, big laughter, city comic itself, witness lesson, bye, oh no, thanks for watching. Alright, so that was a Keep Calling for Iron comic dub, it's not my wallet. That was very good. So, yeah. Just one sec. Okay, I'm skipping the next one. So, yeah, they did. The artist did a very good job of recreating that moment from the SpongeBob episode, and I just saw that this curse reacts to Pink Pie's silliness. This is very good. So,
Yeah, so that was a funny one. Now I'm going to a sad comic, where it's called NLP Comic Dub, An Apple Without Seeds, Sad. So yeah, oh no, with these comic dubs I watch, reacted to, it's going to be like funny ones, the sad ones, to emotional ones, to like some romantic ones, some very emotional ones. And yeah, so I picked a bunch of random ones for this, so yeah. So we're going to start the second one. In 3, 2, 1, bang. An Apple Without Seeds, an audio comic for MLP. Okay, looking at sunset or sunrise. Okay, I think we're at Sweet Apple Acres. And this Applejack. That's far. Must be tired. The art style in this too. A letter of some sort.
So how am I, Doc?
Well, this apple.
Oh.
Tests have come in, and it doesn't look promising.
Uh oh.
Your chances of bearing a child is almost slim to none.
Apple Bloom, what are you doing up so early?
I had a dream. More of a nightmare. You were married, and you had the two cutest, littlest fillies ever. But you rarely came home anymore. And me and Granny Smith and Big Mac missed you and the apple farm. And
it's like right now.
It was awful.
Huh? Like the first actress.
You're there, I'd never leave you. We're apples. And we stick together. Even if I have a family of my own. And that's a big if. Don't worry, sis. At least I'll still be able to take care of you.
Huh? I'll check play by the screen later. So that was LP Comic Dub to Apple Without Seeds. I did not expect that. I did not expect that at all. Whoops. I knew it was gonna be sad, but I didn't expect that. I started getting a little teary eyed, especially when Evelyn started explaining her dream. That was really sad. So, we're something hopefully a little more happier. We're gonna move to a comic dub called Fun Comic Dub featuring Obab Scribbler. So, yeah, we're gonna start this next one in 3, 2, 1, play. Play. Shoot, come on. Don't they just mean it? Sorry, something's up with the video. Come on.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to pause. Sorry about that. I had a little difficulties there, but now we're fine. We can move on to the next one, which is called Fun, a comic dub featuring Obab Scribbler. So yeah, we're gonna start this next one. Okay, we're gonna start this one in 3, 2, 1, play.
Quickie dub starring Cole Petty and Obab Scribbler.
Welcome, every pony, to the third annual Iron Pony Competition!
Nice.
We have returning competitors Applejack and Rainbow Dash, joined by a surprise late entry, Princess Luna!
So you want to be Iron Pony this year, eh, Princess? Oh, I don't consider myself a valid competitor. Only a participant in it for the fun. Fun? Oh, it'll be fun, all right.
The fun has been doubled.
If you enjoy losing a princess in a rough and tumble Iron Pony contest, really? Aren't you worried your fancy slippers will get dirty? you don't want your crown to fall off.
She's not amused.
Oh, you might ruin your your makeup. or your mind could get tangled. actually, Katie, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I mean, face it, you're not an athlete. You're a. I am the princess of the night. Your friend Twilight Sparkle may have the power to tolerate your insufferable heckling. But I do not! You may enjoy your laughter for now, Applejack, Rainbow Dash, for thou hast yet to see what thy Princess of the Night can do!
Rainbow? I just realized something.
What's that, Applejack?
Come now, girls! It's time for the fun!
I'm afraid to die.
Thanks for watching. That was good. That was very good. I would definitely like the voice accent. Oh, Moon would especially great in that. Very good comic. Now we know. So we're moving on to sort of a PMV sort of. It's kind of a MLP version of This Is Halloween, but this is Nightmare Night, featuring Obab Scribbler again and Andy Mongoose. So yeah. One sec. Okay, sorry about that pause again. Apparently I got to the maximum point where I could record my phone, so I had to delete some of my old videos I recorded with it. So now I can hopefully record the rest of my reactions without any more interruptions. So, we're gonna react to This Is a Nightmare Night comic dub. Getting full screen. Okay, we're ready to start this one in 3, 2, 1, play. Okay, which is a comic by, Cervix. Based on This Is Halloween from The Nightmare Before Christmas. It's. Probably hasn't been seen this. This is Nightmare Night. Ooh, Sakura.
It was a long time ago. Longer now.
I like the voice actors for it.
In a place that perhaps you've seen in your dreams. For the story that you are about to be told took place in the magical kingdoms of old. Now, you've probably wondered where nightmares come from. If you haven't, I'd say it's time you begun.
Well, this is the second one. I like, Nightmare Before Christmas. Ooh, I like the music so far.
I like the guitar.
Got some cobwebs on the sign there.
Cops and villains are
Christ.
Wouldn't you like to see something strange? Come behold,
like the song's
a destiny sight. This starts out on Nightmare Night.
This is Nightmare Night.
Like the costumes.
Pumpkin scream in the day of night. This is Nightmare Night. Everyone turn out the light.
Like the art style is.
Hey, Pip. Everybody scream. Nightmare Night is on the scene.
What is Spike? Lyra. Ooh, that's creepy with the snakes.
This is Nightmare Night.
Where is he? I got the people that got the voice characters in this game.
Something's waiting as a bounce and how you'll cry.
This is Nightmare Night. Black and white.
Aren't you scared?
Well, that's just bad.
Twilight and Trixie.
Say it twice. Take a chance and roll the dice. Ride with the moon in the dead of night.
Everybody's free.
Everybody's
free.
Nightmare Night is on the scene.
I think I got a lot of people to do this.
Who's there?
Head Derby. First we say, Discord.
Night, feeling your dreams to the brink. This is Nightmare Night. This is Nightmare Night.
She's a fire shade.
Jump out all your skin!
This is Nightmare Night! Jelly Point.
Wait for Roy.
I like Granny Scott's name. With the Will of Guards. Or Pet Point Guards.
Now! This is Nightmare Night!
I just love the beats of this. This is Nightmare Night comic dub, so and that was very, very good. I especially like the song rendition of This is Halloween, and yeah, and I liked all the people that got into the things. It's really good. I enjoyed. All right, move on to the fifth one of today. It's called LP comic dub. As Twice by The Dare, a romance-slash-comedy comic dub. So, yeah, but obviously, the entire one, this is based out of a more of a Tumblr page thing, and it's like a shift between Twilight and Spike. I'm not exactly, like, all for it, but I think if Twilight and Spike got together, they'd be a little cute and whatnot. But, yeah, we're gonna start this one in 3, 2, 1, play. That's a nice music to start off. As Twice Spike. The Dare. I got Twice in the same line. Looks like Spike's a little older too.
You guys are so cute. I dare you to kiss.
Oh boy.
Thanks. But I'm still pretty shy about all
that. I'm not!
Oh, huh? Spike. Oh. I like the voice actors for them.
Oh, Spike. Room, Spike.
I like the little granny.
Sorry, they dared us! And what if I just want to show you how much I love you?
Oh, gosh.
Sorry.
Oh, poor Spike.
I hope she's not upset. I was just goofing. I thought I was being sweet.
Your turn.
Spike. Oh. Spike's face. Nice. Oh, poor. Spike's turn. No, Bob. No, I just. Why'd you stop? No. Frick! Oh boy. Ah, oh, come on, come on, come on. Load! Come on! Okay. Okay. We're gonna restart this in 3, 2, 1, play.
Win? Can you do that? Can you win at kissing?
I don't know. The worst comic by S twice by Tumblr, alright. That was very cute. Probably played by the glory of the rain winds. Spike played by the boy within the bow tie. That's very cute. And edited by Scribbler. Alright, so yeah, that was as Twilight, as Twilight Spike thing the other day. And that's very cute. I like the retard, especially Twilight's own kissing. Yeah, that was funny. Hopefully I don't get any more, like, pauses. I don't know. Seems like a great connection right now, but I don't know what's up. Maybe it's Firefox. I don't know. But we're going to move on to the next one, which is called LP Comic Dub Granny Panties, a comedy. This should be interesting. So, a little wormy along, but see how this goes. In 3, 2, 1, play. Granny Panties, yeah, LP Comic Dub.
Applejack, I gotta thank you for saving me and helping me get my liver swimming back. So here, you can have this. It's my diving thong. If my diving days are done, it's yours now.
Oh, that's really, thanks.
That's our key.
Oh, for the love of Celestia, this thing is my key. Well, forget that. There's no way I'm showing this to the others. Chrysalis or Somber or whoever can just have a quick trip.
Nice. Chris Cog by Day 6 and Costa. That was funny. Granny Smith voiced by Emo Gak. That was voiced by the lost narrator. Thanks for watching. So yeah, that was Granny Panties, the comic dub, and that was really funny. That was especially funny where it turns out that's her key. That was funny. Alright, now we can move on to an uplifting LP comic dub by the name of It Takes Two. And by the thumbnail, it's going to follow Rainbow Dash and Scootaloo. So yeah, we're going to start this one in 3, 2, 1, play. It Takes Two, LP comic dub. The music plan.
Hey, Scoot! I got something here for you.
Oh, it's a badge!
You did? A winged pony badge? But I can't even fly.
I like the voice
Just
actors.
Just because you can't fly doesn't mean you can't be my partner.
Aww.
And I can't do this next trick solo. So, what do you say? You game?
Let's do it!
Whoosh! Nice!
Best day ever!
Here's a card of PG 55. Nice. Rainbow Dash voiced by the lost narrator. Scooter voiced by Chris. Is it simple? I was like music. Thanks for watching. Alright, so that was the It Takes Two comic dub. Yeah, that one was uplifting. That was really nice of Rainbow Dash to do that for her. So that's a nice one. So, move on to another comedy LP comic dub by the name of Pony Bonicaholic, which decides to involve Berry Punch. So, yeah, it's a little 2 minutes long, so we'll see how this one goes. In 3, 2, 1, play. Bonicaholic LP comic dub. I lost that right again.
Sorry. Saunders out, Everpony.
No!
Oh, man. How am I gonna fight my depressions now?
Don't take it so hard.
How like are you taking accent. It so well?
I don't.
Wait, I got a spare mug for cases like this. Only 20 bits. But Applejack, what about me? You'll survive it. She won't.
She's gonna hate herself.
That's the stuff. Oh, it's empty.
Yeah. Stop!
No!
Listen, Sugar Cube, you can't just go hang yourself. It's bad for business.
Yeah,
Besides. There are more things to life than alcohol.
Her name is Berry
Punch. There are?
Seriously? think back. There must have been a time in your life without drinking.
Today is my 21st birthday. So give me 10 beers, 7 bottles of wine,
wow,
and 5
really
glasses
out.
Of booze.
You mean the usual?
The usual?
You know it.
She went like this to the chemistry exam?
Yeah, she asked it.
Yeah, she asked it.
Barry, no! That's mine!
I want your bottle!
I want your bottle! Toro has just been drinking? What the hell?
Oh my god.
Isn't there anything else you like?
Donuts! Fresh donuts!
Oh, she's getting fat.
They're best with cider!
Look at here.
Oh, very punchy.
There is something else she likes. Sexual harassment.
I suspect the donuts.
I'm all yours.
I don't need no woman. I have my donuts.
You know, for kids.
We're just coming by WW Brothers. Applejack, Raymond, as Shirley, and Barry's mom, voiced by the Lost Narrator. Barry Punch, Mini Wets, and Pink Pie, voiced by Kate Bug. Bartender, voiced by Great R. Period. Polly Joe, voiced by Goomba Brony. Thanks for watching. That was definitely a funny one. Barry Punch was definitely very good in this. That last bit was picked by the end, that's very funny. So we're on to the second to last one today. LP caught up by the name of the Moonlight, which is a sad / horror / supernatural comic. So yeah, this should be interesting. This one's also a little over 2 minutes long. So we're gonna start this one in 3, 2, 1, play. The Moonlight, an audio comic for MLP. Take a quick sip. Some noises. In some dungeon of some sort. Or something. Oh, it's screwed. Well. Is this a mental facility or something? Dang. I like the music guys playing this. Look at the moonlight, at the moon. Shine the moonlight, yeah. Her eyes are glowing. What's going on? What the hell? Whoa, what the heck? How does she get like that much strength? Oh, she's werepony! I did not see that coming. That's cool. I like werewolves. That's cool. Prince of Kong by Matt Kotaru. That's that being our thing. Oh, I like this bit, this music. Form and edit by the scribbler. It's got a fan fiction page. So yeah, that was the Moonlight comic dub. That's very interesting. I liked how it evolved Screw Loose, and how apparently she was a werepony and she turned to one when the moonlight shined on her. That's very cool. So yeah, now we're gonna move on to the very last one LP comic dub today, which is called Book Fortress, an LP film comic dub number 1. So yeah, followed by the thumbnail follows a young Shiny Armor and Twilight. So yeah, we'll see how this one turns out. And this one's a little over 2 minutes long. See how this one turns out in 3, 2, 1, play.
Twilight, what are you doing?
Behold, my impervious book fortress.
Oh, I like the voice actors.
No one can break through its impenetrable wall.
Smarty Pants.
And Smarty Pants is captain of the guard.
Hey, Smarty Pants.
Aw, that's really cute, Twilight, but can you let me pass?
What's the passphrase?
Password?
Oh, a passphrase, huh? Is it...
Will
you let me go into the kitchen, please?
Nope.
Smarty Pants is the best captain of the guard?
Very true, but that's not it.
Man.
I love my big brother so much that I'll let him pass because he's so hungry and really wants his apple fritter from the fridge?
Not even close.
Is it... I love you, Twilight?
Aww. So sweet, Shiny.
I love you too, BBBFF. But that's not the best phrase either.
Aww.
It was worth a shot.
Oh, it is cute.
Nice try. But trying to use your Beverly Charm, I'm going to add other conditions to pass my fortress.
What's gonna do?
Fair enough. I'd do anything for that apple fritter right now.
Anything?
You have to sing the passphrase. And do the dance that goes with it.
Huh? What do you mean?
Oh,
come on, Twilight. Only you and Princess Cadence can do that.
Those are the conditions. Otherwise, Captain Smarty Pants won't let you pass.
But...
No exceptions.
Nice.
Okay. Only for you, Twilight. Sunshine, ladybugs awake. Clap your hooves and do a little shake.
Impressive!
Princess Cadence! How much did you see?
The whole thing. I must say, you did a pretty good job. I especially liked the do little shake part.
Oh my gosh.
I agree. Alright, Captain Smarty Pants, let him pass.
That's okay, Twilight. Suddenly I don't feel very hungry anymore.
Oh, Shining.
Fortress Compile, Medical Compile, Europe. Pass. Young. Used by Dan Ingram, Go Potion, Monster Material. Edited by Tarot, Hiddleton, Warner Cross Hasbro, and I'll play Chris Magic. Alright, so that was the Book Fortress comic dub. That was very good. Especially. I like the young versions of those three. Twilight is really cute. I liked Shining Armor, especially where he had to do the Sunshine Sunshine little dance. I liked when Cadence popped out and saw him do that. That was really good. One moment. So yeah, overall that's all my reactions to all those OP comic dubs. And I apologize for all those interruptions I had. I did not expect any of those. But I will try to fix it when I'm editing. I'll put a little intermission segments in between those. So, see how that goes. But, so yeah. Overall, that's the end of this 1 year anniversary reaction video. Make sure to like this video. Subscribe to the channel for more videos. And then comment down below. Section 1 video I should react to next. So, once again, I wanted to thank everyone that has helped me get this far on my channel, and hopefully I could get this to another for my second year anniversary. So let's see how far I can get. So overall, that's the end of this video. Hope to see you guys very soon. Bye!